Hello everyone, I'm Pacific the Casual Gamer, and welcome back to another video. And today I want to talk about if Kingdom Come Deliverance is a good casual game. I've only put 20 hours into this game, but it is very apparent whether it is a casual game or not a casual game. Really quickly, this video is sponsored by those of you at Steam that upvote my stuff there. You know, give me that little bit extra money that will help me, you know, buy more games. Or, I don't know, we'll see where Steam it goes. But anyways, to the video. Kingdom Come Deliverance is a medieval game, you know, basically Medieval Simulator 2018, but it does it really well. So in terms of, like, quality of a game itself, Kingdom Come Deliverance is one of the highest quality medieval games I've ever played. It has great graphics, which graphics don't really mean a lot to me, but it has great storytelling, and it uses the graphics, it has a charm to it as well. So, you know, as a quality of a game, it's amazing. So this might sway your answer a little bit. But in terms of casual gaming, you know, the first thing I look at is how simple of a game this game is. And it's kind of, I'm 50-50 on it. The only really complicated parts to this game is there's some, the sword fighting, complicated. All right, very, very complicated. But the other complicated part is when you do a quest that involves investigation. Is you have to pay attention and, you know, investigate on your own. The thing doesn't say, let's just say I'm investigating, I'm just making up a quest in my head. Like, there's a food seller who sells poisonous food, and I have to figure out who it is, right? It's just gonna say you have to figure it out in this town. And it doesn't say there's a food seller here, a food seller here, and a food seller here. It says the location is in the town, and it circles the whole town with, like, this thing. Okay, you're in the right town. Talk to the food sellers and figure it out. So, that's kind of 50-50 again on that, too. If you just use your investigation skills, you're probably able to figure it out. But other than that, the other parts of the game, archery is pretty simple. You know, blacksmith, merchanting, sneaking. Lockpicking is simple, but it's very hard to master. And your actions, you feel the impact of your actions in the story, but in terms of your skills and, you know, your player abilities, they're really easy to understand. There's not, I can't say that there's not metas, because there are metas, but your game is not going to be ruined if you don't know a meta or you don't follow a meta. And that's a big thing for this medieval RPG, is that you don't have to meta your character out, right? If I want to, let's just say, be really good at sword fighting and all of a sudden I switch to an axe, yeah, I'm going to have some trouble, you know, learning the axe skill, but I have that sword to fall back on, and training with the axe is not going to be a problem. Then there's also, you know, perks. You know, you can only pick this perk or that perk, and it's really, there's not a lot of metas, right? Like, there's a perk in the game where you can drink twice as much beer before you're drunk, or half as much wine. Or you can drink twice as much wine to get drunk, but half as much beer to get drunk, right? Like, it depends on which one you want, right? So, really, there's no meta. It just, you figure out, oh, my character is good at this, and you play your character the way that you want to play it. In terms of raw time that you have to put into this game, though, I'm 20 hours in, and I'm pretty sure I finally finished the, quote, tutorial section, because I finally, I think, like, I want to say, like, 12 hours in, seven hours in, because by the way, you're going to have to look some stuff up for one of the quests, just so you know, but 7 hours in, 7-8 hours in, I finally did my first big, large military battle, and after that big, large military battle, then I started getting quests that were similar to stuff that I did before. Which, they were similar, but storytelling-wise and interactive-wise, they were different anyways. So it's like, eh, really? But, like, it took me 7 hours to just experience one of everything in this game. Sword fight, you know, combat, you're going to experience multiple times, of course. But just one of everything. And I don't even know if there's, like, I don't even know if I've done everything yet. I still haven't done alchemy yet, and I'm 20 hours into the game. But, you know, this is a game that is a time investment. Let's just say for 1 year, you have 2 hours a week to put into this game. Okay? 2 hours a week. Apparently, the game has 100 hours of gameplay. This is going to take you a whole year to beat. This is going to take you a whole year to play. Alright? So, for the casual gamer who doesn't have a lot of time, this game is not for you. Now, for the casual gamer with a lot of time, here's what I say. Invest. You're going to have to invest time into this game. But you don't have to do it in a hardcore, figure-out-the-metas way. You have, like, 7 different files. This game is a good casual game for those who have time. If you don't have time, I mean, unless you want a very, very long interactive version of medieval storytelling, if this is your thing, if this is all you've ever wanted was an amazing medieval game, go for it, go for it. But this is for people who have a lot of time. This game fits the people who have a lot of time to finish it, really play through it, understand the world, not speed through it. That was one of the mistakes I made at one point, was I sped through it, and it literally cost me. I had to solve this problem. Like, I had to do this quest multiple times because I kept dying on it. So, really, you're going to have to put a lot of time into this game. So that's what I say. The casual gamer with a lot of time, this game is pretty fun. You know, it's a good storytelling game. Not a lot of metas, so it's good. Hardcore gamers, there is metas that you can exploit. And you can also get really good at sword fighting. But for those who don't have a lot of time, this game really isn't a good fit. So this game is a casual game, though, 100%. There's not a lot of hardcore elements, so if you're hardcore, stay away from it. But that's it for this video, guys. Thank you for watching. If you enjoyed, you can tell me in the comments below. Subscribe if you're new. What do you think of Kingdom Come? Do you think it's a casual game like I do? I think it is. Well, see you guys in the next episode, stream, vlog, or Steam and post of whatever I decide to make.